I reviewed my conversation with the woman. According to her, the book contains information about how to attach a soul to a dead person. So it's sort of a how to create, I think, some type of a, doesn't directly say it. I think we face these type of creatures. Lives unnaturally extended. They're not. They wouldn't be exactly vampires, but maybe more like the woman we've met in the graveyard district, the one attached to that tower that taught us the Ingwitten language. Sort of a. More of a stable version, but still feeding on people. And her initial investigation was about immortality, potential immortality. Yeah. So I don't see anything particularly good to come out of it. She sort of tried to sell it as ha being a
Of course.
solution to the Hollowborn children, but we know what's causing the Hollowborn children. She's not going to be able to provide a solution. It's either us or no one, very likely. So I'm going to just talk to the Grimda and tell her that she's trying to get it.
Gods keep you.
An animancer named Nedin asked me to retrieve the theorems of Pengram from the Elder Archives. Grimbra's impressive frown deepens. Thank you for letting me know. I'll be sure to tuck the tome away from prying eyes and see that this Nedin never sets foot in here again. In the meantime, here, a token of our appreciation.
Is this what we wanted? To see her barred entirely? It seems a fearsome price to pay. Knowledge dangled just out of reach makes a tempting prize for any soul.
Yeah, I'm not quite sure I want to do that. Hello? I don't intend to give her the book, but I'm not sure I want to her bar from here either. At the same time, I think she might take matters into her
Of
own
course.
hands. Here's the thing about that, though. I'll tell what she's been up to.
Good day, stranger.
I'm not 100% sure on that, though. But she's not the person to. I'm not sure if it's gonna do anyone any good. At the edge of all known things added, we do need to visit the stronghold. Rewards 50% experience. Maia's Codex. 1,000 to 3,000 copper in treasure. Grand item, major item. The famous and wealthy Rawatai scholar Amaya has been compiling a massive codex of Eora's varied legends over her long life. Pulling from Amawa sources, as well as from Aedir, Old Velia, and Ixomital Plains, and Nausithaq, the work is truly gargantuan, spanning thousands of pages. While she has had scribes busy for the last 2 decades copying her current body of work, few folk tales have remained out of her reach. She has attempted to contact the elder Glanfallen of the White That Wends, arrange a special meeting with the Aedir in Sigthrua, and sit among the most revered Rhiav in Eir Glanfad. In all attempts, she has been unsuccessful due to various threats that stand in her way. These last subjects will be the final chapters of her life's work. and she is seeking experienced adventurers to assist her. Ranger and Druid. Care. Assign Sagani. Right. Am I going to visit the woman and tell her I've denied her access? It doesn't seem necessary. Okay, what exactly do we have left? We have the bounties, sealed missive to deliver, find and capture three rare songbirds. Not sure I want to do that. Dragon eggs, blades from the ancient paths. We probably want.
Hi.
Can't talk about anything new with him.
Hey.
I'm going to the stronghold. Actually, I somewhat interested in visiting the graveyard district. I don't expect anyone's there. At the same time, something might have happened there. Not exactly my current concern, though. I'll go to the stronghold. We'll need to switch people. I want Duran's part of the party. I'm thinking of going down toward the, in the maze. After that, we can fight the little fight with the other lord for the control of the castle. It might be a thing that's holding other things from happening too.
I must say, I'm impressed.
So I'll treat this as a bottleneck, and I want to get rid of it.
Farewell.
Farewell. Not sure if this is the best possible party for us to move forward with, but we'll give it a shot.
No one wants to talk?
Right. Oh, goddammit. There was something here, someone here we had to meet. We'll meet with him, then head down. We only have enough spells, so we don't have to necessarily rest. We probably have a perception bonus for the resting.
Of course.
This was a prestige contact.
Greetings, Lord Huron. My name is Berald. If you have the time, I have an urgent matter I'd like to discuss.
Very well. Let's hear it.
I have been tasked with meeting with representatives from the Fisher Crane tribe near Thaneborg. It is my hope to come to peaceful terms. Unfortunately, I haven't had much practice with the Clanfathan language, and the Fisher Crane are, by nature, very reclusive. I fear that the circumstances are ripe for a misunderstanding. You yourself, I hear, have had some dealings with the Glen Fathoms. I would welcome any assistance or advice you may offer.
Traveling advice? I see to it that your safe passage to Aeon Glanfat, I'll have someone escort you.
Oh, with whom will I be traveling?
Iravius is Glanfathan. His knowledge of the region should be helpful.
Thank you, my lord. We'll set out right away.
Iravius will be busy for 6 days. That's fine. We weren't planning on taking him with them into the maze anyway. And I think we... It might do him some good to go back. He at least knows things, even if they don't welcome him. And he's in a very different position from what he used to be in. So, right, I think we're just gonna head down. Level 8, was it? I think it was level 8. Sweet Jesus. Their levels weren't all that big, but fairly tough. But that was a lot of levels ago. And we'll probably get a level up before we reach the bottom anyway, if we have what it takes to reach the bottom. I mean, if it's around level 15, and we are around level 11, we should at the very least be able to push forward 3 to 4 levels. No. Is it this? Can I spot something interesting here? I think this is just a quick exit out of this place, but at the same time, maybe not. Let in key assassins.
Hold there.
A robed man stands in the doorway, his gaze moving between you and Kanarua. The reason I think this might not be an exit, because what's the point? You have the main staircase anyway, leading back up. So you have instant travel through the map system, so why would you need another exit? It's unnecessary. It might be that, but you don't need it.
Oh, not this again. Now, of all times.
Yeah, my feelings exactly. Kanaa gnashes his teeth together, his face darkening with fury. Another robed figure, a woman, looks at you.
So this is the Watcher. You made this very convenient running to ground in the same place. Our hunting parties have joined and we have the advantage of numbers. Make this easy on yourself and surrender. We'll end it quickly.
How did you get in here?
We seek the company of shadows, that our labors may remain secret.
Right.
If thou killest, you leave.
I wonder what level assassins these are. Because these sort of seem like they're here to stop us from going into the maze. That was a long time ago. I'm thinking this might be a horrible slaughter on them, but we'll see. Well, they're barely shit. You weaken them. Give the acolyte to try. Mind Render. Yeah, they're not really doing anything to us. I'll just paralyze him a little bit.
Alright then.
Kinda looks over at the body, shaking his head. What a waste. He turns to you. I don't see why they bothered. What harm can a broken tablet do? Or any artifact? They aren't even grand fathoms. How long do you think they were stuck waiting up here? Kind of smirks. A good long while, I hope. Yeah, I don't think they were here for the tablet, but why exactly? I can understand them coming after me. You did tell me it could stop Rawatai from trying to conquer the known world. Kinda gives a startled laugh.
That might be overstating it. It could have inspired peace, at least.
He smiles thinly.
If it existed.
Kinda prods at a tooth with his tongue, thinking.
It doesn't make sense. All they could know is that we were descending into the ruins, and that was enough to warrant their attack.
What's your point?
It seems like if either of us are going to find any answers, they aren't going to be in there.
He jerks a thumb back towards the stairs.
The Ledenki know something we don't, and they mean to keep it that way. Your enemies are mine. I owe you much for all that you've done for me. Perhaps there will be answers for both of us at the end of our journey.
Got to hear it. Let's go! Ledenki Wizard Grimoire. Well, we'll probably take that. Best can go into storage. Looking from the healing potions they have, they aren't that amazing. I would imagine this can be opened from the other side, and there are stairs there, so yeah, I think it's just an escape path from the bottom. Ooh, what's this? Minor spell reflection for 87 seconds. So they weren't total losers, but yeah, not exactly great either. I mean, I can't even see the difference in our health, for example. So yeah, they probably weren't. They weren't quite up to the task.
You must get.
This should be the main staircase, or if not this, the next one. The outside hatch in the stronghold would have allowed us to access the main staircase immediately. But I suppose we would have never really encountered those assassins if we would have used that. Right, 1, 3, 5, and 8. 2 hours. Okay, we wrap this up. Did we wrap up something after this too? This was the vampire level.
I shall be quiet.
I don't think we did level 9, so 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Right. I'd say we are definitely past the halfway point at least. Not sure if it's 15. Crystals. Ah. Crystal spiders, maybe? They would be more or less the appropriate level, I guess. This Adra has turned a dull shade of crimson. Entire sections of it have crumbled away from the walls and ceiling. But we had vampires on the previous level. I'm expecting something worse on every level. At the same time, in some ways, the vampire threat might be more troublesome than the direct level would indicate, because they turn my own guys against the group, neutralize the group cohesion. Just a tough fighter cannot do that. Yeah, this is clearly a torture room of some sort. Right, I'm seeing a lot of spikes. Don't particularly want to go there. Might not have a choice. What? There might be some kind of a...
Your thoughts must flow deeply indeed.
Ability that allows you to avoid damage. I have no idea what that would be, though. I'm not going there now. It seems like I have no idea what I would gain from this, and I'm going to bleed heavily in order to get those. So maybe there's a better way to do this. Maybe heavier armoring would allow you to tank more of the damage. Maybe certain attributes would allow you to evade the damage. Looks suspicious. Swamp? Obviously.
You're not getting through me.
Keeping an eye out.
Diamonds. Bone pile. Why did the window appear here?
A simple test.
Very tough to open the door. Yeah, we have 49 lockpicks. We can spend them.
That's
one.
Settled.
What is this? Spectres. Sinquala. So, Banshee.
Braved up.
There's a lot of specters. Physical attacks would work well, or fortitude, against fortitude defense. We do have the corrosive, whatchamacallit. These are probably too tough for it to be all that effective. We do have the freezing, but they're spirits, they're probably very resistant to freezing. Right. We would want fire. Not sure if it would work all as well. Right. We could try to weaken their attributes a little bit. Okay.
My mind feels sharp as steel.
Good for you. Paralyzed for 5 seconds. Right. This might be level wise better than the vampires. But we're much less vulnerable to their bullshit. The skull is thrown back in a grimace of agony. Oh, hooray for torture. Boiling spray. White leaf. Immunity to frightened and sickened. And weakened. Scroll of paralysis. So it looks like spirits. Hireling payday. Ah, so you can bypass this
room. I can do that. That's settled.
Yeah, I'm not sure why I would go there then. I'm sure there's wonderful things in those little boxes, but I can't think of anything. Ooh, a Withrak. Immune to charmed, confused, dominated, groundhold. So I guess it was a Withrak that we saw with the spiders earlier. It's a psychic creature. We know that much for certain. I don't think we're quite as immune to the abilities I thought we were. I would imagine that its will is insanely strong. So, can we attack something else? Soul ignition, burn damage. Right. Let's go with that.
My mind.
is near death. Definitely weak on the armor and fortitude front. I need to learn more about Withrax.
Of course.
The Withrak are extremely rare, very dangerous creatures with natural cipher abilities. They are mostly humanoid in shape, slightly taller and thinner than humans, but boast fanged spider-like heads. Similarly to spiders, they are capable of spinning silk. Rather than creating webs, they use the skill to fashion complex hive structures, along with their own very intricate and fine robes. Males and female Withrak are indistinguishable from each other. They are primarily spellcasters and mental manipulators, like cyphers, though they will also attack with their fangs when forced into close quarters. Withrak's psionic powers allow them to communicate mentally with one another. Like many social insectoids, their society includes a variety of specific roles, including scouts and defenders. Despite their extreme intelligence and power, Withrak are not a major force in the world due to their extremely low birth rates. While these low birth rates are likely responsible for their famed hostility toward other races, they have also made the Withrak highly altruistic when it comes to their own kind. They will defend their nests to the death. It's a level 8 creature, so it's not that powerful. But psionic abilities are dangerous, very dangerous. I should know. If there were a couple of cyphers, you could easily kill people with a couple of shots. Paralyze them, dominate them, all kinds of nasty things. I think as long as we're going to face individual ones, they're trivial. We're going to face a group, it's a huge problem. Are they going to have a hive here? Hive level of Withrak. We do have immunity to certain types of abilities.
Fire shows me something new.
Through drug use. I can't think of a better use for drugs than that. Also, crystal eaters. Oh, what exactly do we have here as an option? We'll have to go forward. So. The Withrak is the higher priority.
Your thoughts must flow deep, deep.
Feel free to attack it. What the fuck is it doing? It's doing something. Crystal Eater Freezing Peeler, 3 grazes, 3 hits. So it's going to do damage on our area. It's quite a lot cold damage, in fact.
Margrin's fire cast light.
Okay, that's another serious problem.
Something over there.
Withrak brain. broken blade. Find more pieces of the blade. I found part of a shattered plate. It isn't much use like this, but perhaps it can be reforged with if I want the rest of it. I found both halves of broken plate, but I don't have a pommel for it really. And I'm sure I'll find all of it here. The maze in due time. So we'll just try to get to the bottom of things. I have high hopes for the blade. Hopefully it's a one-handed sword. Soulbound item would be nice. Spectre.
Rave.
Okay. That one get paralyzed, focus fire on that.
Spot.
Detonation on death.
If secrets whisper here, I shall listen for them.
Seems to work more against themselves than against any of my guys. It could be one of those things that it was a good thing some levels ago, but now I'm being so resistant to it that the damage is too low. Crystal Eater Spiderling. Hello, Crystal Eater. How are we gonna handle this? Oh, with tracks. What is it doing? It's doing the ice thing, right? It's a second with track. I just withdraw. And now comes the... Right. Okay. Now they're starting to be dangerous. You need to make sure our cipher can actually cipher. You, I don't care what you do. Just help get rid of them. Good. Now. Need to ruin their deck. Everyone goddamn paralyzed here. So at least least one with Rack down.
We've been poisoned!
I don't care what we've been do. Ooh, ah, you were the one here. Thought it was the fighter.
Hey.
Okay, knock it down so he can't be too big of a threat.
I'm ready.
Raise up, we lost your lead.
Hey.
Let's see what lies this way.
They're somewhat troublesome, but not too dangerous. Not in these quantities. Need more. The crystal spiders are very dangerous, but they also spam the ice attack right at the start and don't seem to cast it twice. So if you can, someone has to take it. But not the entire group doesn't have to fight there, so it's not too bad. The spikes look sharp enough to cleave bone. Okay. Better not jump in there then. Pagra. Atrabeetle. Anyone switch weapons lately? No? I don't really recall what these are supposed to do. One of them is stunned for 10 seconds, one is blinded, one is blinded. Right. Get rid of the stunned one, it should be very easy to hit. Fight with the Atrabeetle, but the rest of you need to help out here. Can I do anything about spirit creatures? Something fire. Burn damage, area effect. This would be the ultimate burn damage. And it wouldn't attack friendlies, but there's shadows. It's a heavy spell to throw against shit like this. Oh, area effect prune. I think we will not exactly have great area effects from these on that front. I am leaning toward actually casting something though. It's gonna be a big problem if we don't. Are you casting something? Squad. Ignites the powerful zeal within allies that manifests in an aura that shocks any enemies nearby. They actually have a higher resistance to that. Hitting with this is not guaranteed by any means. You still aiming at something? I can save her life though. I don't think she's actually in any real threat of dying anyway.
This thing is doing
little slowly but surely getting results. No more Adder Beetle. 51, 29. I like those. Could have gone worse, should have gone better.
Quiet as a calm sea,
which the spirits are always troublesome. It's impossible to hold any kind of line against them. They just come right through any defensive lines to the target. I think they're rogues, basically. They have rogue special abilities. I don't know what rogues get, though. But I would guess... Well, there's rogues... Barbarians and monks that I don't really know what they can do. I think everything else we've seen. And we got to play a low level rogue at the start. It had some special abilities. Two topaz. Withdraw.
Yes.
This thing isn't doing the job.
Following your lead.
That's all you can do. Range damage it is then.
Spot on.
My mind feels sharp as steel.
Got this. Spot on.
84 points. Yeah, that's probably enough points. Better detonate them. mind control them. I'll do the silent scream. It's not going to be very effective against these guys, but it doesn't matter. I can kill them through normal means.
Spot on!
Don't even score it!
Spot! Dawn!
I have them! Light, flame, and sound. We'll keep to ourselves.
Alright then.
Right then. Is this ice or slime? Exceptional greatsword. I don't care what it is. Stairs down. Did not notice that. Not particularly tough level.
Margrin's fire cast
we
light
did not explore it fully,
places.
Though. At the same time, if we go there, we'll just wound ourselves and we're
following
forced
your lead.
To rest anyway.
Hey.
So that was level 9. Getting to level 10. Could probably do a couple of levels. If we don't want to stretch things out too much. Looks like a very small level. Like 4 of these screens. So what's the catch?
Of course.
Shade. This is a challenge area. Definitely switch to melee, you fools.
I'm ready. One repels me.
Paralysis. Still very reluctant to use certain type of spells, but I think we sort of must. This is intolerable otherwise. Okay, we successfully managed to paralyze you guys. Sure, we should do anything but just keep attacking them. We can do a few other things, but what is this? Crush them, it's stunned. Okay, this is actually quite nice. They have a fairly weak endurance.
Don't even blowing it down.
Raise down Philothili.
Trap rooms.
Margaret's fire casts light in dark places.
Hmm?
Brah!
Hey.
Still, we're in fairly good health. We have a lot of special abilities, spells, so... no major problems.
Alright then.
As I said, this should be a very more small area.
You're not getting up.
Might as well try to stun them. We'll get the focus back.
And what does the flame reveal?
It requires a proper key. It's just these type of spiders. No, of course not. We do need to focus on the crystal ones. They're significantly more dangerous.
If that's not your lead.
Light, flame, and sound.
Has to be something else besides spiderlings here. We moved past the spiderling level of opponents some time ago. Stairs down. A very small area. This is an extra and probably exists to have the key to this area.
If that's the last you leave.
My mind feels sharp as steel.
I'm gonna level up. No, we are learning more about the spiders. I think that's it.
My mind feels.
Well, this is looking bad. We do have to move.
We're
not moving anywhere. Fuck. Okay. Can we. Something about this one? Weak against mine, that's basically what they have. Other than that, they're actually quite good. So this would do a lot of damage, has 10 damage resistance piercing. That's a huge amount of damage really, and they're weak against piercing. Let's give that a try. Ooh, what exactly did it do? Doesn't work like that. We'll have to go closer. Trying to buff my damage. Wrong spell. Trying to get critical hits. To hit them. I guess this is it. will very likely hit, do a decent amount of damage though. What are you doing? Paralysis. Okay, if the paralysis hit, then they're gonna take a massive amount of damage. Crystal leaders just aren't particularly dangerous.
Let's see what lies this way.
Rope like strands of webbing. Hoop has. And get a key. Ancient crumbling bones are all that remains of countless victims. There's a key. Adra key. It's an optional thing, but I'm very interested in this optional thing. All important level ups too. Not sure what we should take. Lore would allow us to use some scrolls, but we aren't particularly using scrolls. We'd also go for extra athletics, but it doesn't give us too much. Extra survival doesn't give us too much either. It might be better to go with other things. Mechanics would allow us to get better use out of our traps. We have quite a lot of traps. So it might not be a bad thing. If we do find top opponents, ability to just lay down a trap with each guy would help. And plus 3 trap accuracy, I guess, per point. Left with extra points. So plus 12 trap accuracy. I'm not a fan. The larger negatives on the good traps are like 20, 25, so that doesn't barely covers half of it. I will re-scrolls. I don't care. More athletics maybe. Minus go full in with what we know. Wary Defender, plus 5 defenses except deflection. Modal. No. Bonus knockdowns, I don't care about any of these. We could go for extra attack capabilities at this point. Maybe another weapon focus so we don't have to rely on the sword only. A single-handed blunt weapon, the flails are actually quite good. Morningstars are two-handed, so flail or a mace would be nice. So anyone actually use a flail? It's an adventurous weapon. We'd also get poleaxe, estoc, wand and warbow, but flails would be the only good one in this one. Dagger, rapier, mace, they're all good, but we'll maybe be interested in the mace. This has slashing and piercing, mace for the crushing. Might have a extra mace too. At the same time, I don't know. Looking at the others, the club, sabers. The saber is actually quite nice. Might not be a bad option. Sabers, club, stiletto. Maybe the ruffian one. Alternatively, extra enemies engaged. And defenses against blind, stuck, prone, hobbled, dazed. These are also very, very goddamn annoying. We can protect ourselves from paralysis and petrified through spells. Mental abilities are a different matter. We have the drugs that protect against us to some extent. But maybe these would be better. Plus 10 will. It can be caused through other than will though. But. Maybe increases character's will defense. I think I'll take this. It is just incredibly aggravating to be affected by that. But again, we do have the drugs. Maybe we should take the secondary weapon. At the same time, we are not relying on any damage he can do with the enemy. Not at all. So I'll take the plus 10 will. Right. Experience max. So there's a level cap at 12. So do not save skill points, I guess. Single point to spend. Spend it. Ooh. I want another tier 6 ability. We have the disintegration or something like that. Full area of effect, crushing damage, prone. This is a nice thing. Area around an allied target. That's in a way quite nice because it's pretty much guaranteed to hit. Sometimes the enemies move or they get killed, but this is very unlikely in this case. Mind affecting, dazed, confused, dazed and confused. I'll try the amplified wave. Crushing doesn't damage anything special, but it's extra damage. The prone effect on it is much more useful, I think. It can't take action for pretty much 12 seconds. Talents. Brutal backlash. The Cypher's psychic backlash becomes especially traumatic, inflicting a small amount of raw damage on the target on a hit. Passive. Once per encounter, foe will be stunned and take the raw damage. Yeah, I don't care. Not in the slightest. ...20% of hits convert to crits against targets with low endurance, plus 0.5 to crit damage multiplier against targets with low endurance. I'll take this. All attacks at enemies with low endurance convert some hits to criticals, those crits do additional damage. It's a passive ability, we don't have to know anything extra. Just... She's one of the hardest hitting damage dealers in the entire group and always does some kind of area of effect or jumping up, jumps from 4 to 4 ability, so there's a very good chance she'll hit low endurance opponents fairly regularly. Can take more lore. I'm taking more lore. Then what? I can spend either 1 point in stealth or survival. I don't know. Stealth? Gotta spend it somewhere. Ooh, 6-level spells. So 7 and 8 is not even accessible in this game. Corrode damage, full area of effect against fortitude. Calls a black ring of necrotic energy into being that spreads out in all directions, causing corrode damage to enemies it touches and potentially destroying those with low endurance. Yeah, I think I'll take that. Arcane Reflection could be good against something. Problem is, as long as we have the group to fight with, it's not that relevant. It also only protects my caster. So I'll take the Death Ring. Corrode damage, area of effect. Can destroy low endurance opponents. Again, it doesn't do a huge amount of damage, but we can throw it around freely. How about expose vulnerabilities? Full area effect, minus 5 damage reduction, minus 10 deflection, minus 10 concentration for 29 seconds. Against will. Why don't I have this? I'll take it. I can use the other caster to take the Death Ring. Last talent. Hardened Veil. Strengthens the wizard's arcane veil, providing a particularly high deflection bonus. Plus 25 deflection. So, I think it's plus 50 deflection now, so 75 deflection for 14.5 seconds. Yeah, that could be a lifesaver, very, very likely. I'll take it. I'm relying on it fairly often, in fact. Against certain type of opponents, the line just isn't gonna hold. So the Hardened Veil, or Veil in general, has bought me time. Extra 25 deflection is actually quite a lot. What are we not using? We are using the Noxious Burst from time to time, I suppose. It's not that impressive. Exposed vulnerabilities, yeah, I think I'd rather take that. Minus 30% attack speed and move speed on enemies. Not using that all that much though. But there's nothing particularly wrong about it. Wait. Spectre. Three banshees. Oh, this is gonna suck.
Yes? Brave up.
Still, it's Spectres are weak to fortitude, but Banshees are certainly not. Okay. Paralyzed and stuck. Might as well give that a go, even if it doesn't have great chance to succeed. If it does succeed, it's pretty much an instant death for them. Alright, you're not allowing them to pass, you son of a bitch. Okay, blinded. Paralyzed. We got 3 hits and 1 critical.
Silence surrounds me.
Rod of Pale Shades. Attacks can stun on critical hits. Inflicts disorienting for 5 seconds on hit. Exceptional accuracy and damage. Piercing and slashing. This is a great rod. Unique rod. Yep. Useful. You have basically a standard weapon. Maybe give it to him. I don't know. Yeah, we're casting a lot with her, but we do need to regain the focus too. We can enchant this to be even better. More accuracy, more damage. So more criticals, more stunning.
Course.
If secrets whisper here, I shall listen for them.
So it's just for the unique item. Oh, at least we cleared a couple of levels. Starting to reach the maximum level, we're getting good items. Item pieces of a powerful sword. We're not going to get access to a new level of scrolls, so I don't see why I should put extra lore for this guy. We're much better off doing something else, and I'm inclined to have that something be mechanics. We can't get it too far, but I'd like to have someone who might spot traps besides the cleric. And just in case I switch the cleric out, to be somewhere there to pass through some simple obstacles. Alternatively, we could go in accuracy bonus versus a creature type. We would have points for that. Right, that's a huge benefit versus extra point of damage resistance, that's nothing. Our last invocation. It has to be something besides a summon. I'm not sure if it's... Should I take the 5 phrase one? 3 phrase ones aren't particularly good though. Friendly area effect. Protection against slashing and shocking. Shock damage, crush damage. Yeah, this is rubbish. Yeah, we can get them faster, but I don't care about them. Even if we get them. Core area of effect, paralyzed. This is a powerful one. Paralyzing cone. Four phrases. At the same time, the Cypher can sort of do this on a regular basis. Willow Wisp, no. Area of effect, terrified. We have special spells for this. Charmed, it's nice, but again, we can just charm ourselves. The wizard and Cypher can do a lot of charming and dominating. Drake, not interested. Friendly area of effect, revive with 59 endurance could be very nice, because yeah, if the fight lasts for a long time, it's quite probable that we're going to get casualties. Although the paladin can resurrect, so can the cleric. Now we would have the thing is, this guy is a standard issue on any group. A lot of freeze damage. A lot of freeze damage. Attacks enemies in 7 directions around the chanter with bolts of freezing ice. Area of effect, length 11.6 meters. I would have to see this in action to say if it's really good. It does a lot of freeze damage, and against reflex, that's usually not that strong on a lot of creatures. Buff on your own guys. Not exactly impressed. Another buff. So, I'm somewhat interested in the resurrection or the attack. And that's about it. The rest aren't bad, it's just I might have better. Especially the paralysis wouldn't be bad. But on the 5th phrase, we just have the summon spell now. And it's fine. But yeah, I think the revive is gonna be the thing. Hopefully we'll never have to rely on it. But the Chanter has good survivability. It's quite often that he's one of the last few that are standing. So he might be able to facilitate a comeback in a tough fight. Extra endurance regeneration. I don't think we can even use this weapon to play. Not sure if that's a huge problem though. We even have a weapon for this. I'm not sure we do. Battle axe, sword, Morningstar. Alright, we would at least want to have a different one. Pike. War hammer, arbalest, arquebus, great sword, saber, stiletto, club, pistol, blunderbuss. I'm not sure. Defensive abilities are always welcome too. This one gets dominated or charmed very, very often, and I'm sort of sick of that. Maybe the will saving throws might be the thing. We take the charm, terrified, frightened, dominated thing. We're still gonna be vulnerable to a lot of psyker will attacks. I'll take the bull's will. At least it should help things a little bit. Not sure. Is everyone on level 12? No. And a no.
Light, flame.
I think I'll end things here. We got 2 levels down, we did a lot of leveling up. So maybe in a couple of sessions we might reach the bottom, depending on what type of levels we're experiencing. Yeah, these seem to be now very small levels. Again, just 4 of these screens combined and that's the entire level. Very, very small. Is that a... Yeah, it's the master staircase. I'd like to at least to reach that, so we can have easy access up to this. Level 11. Yeah, I'd say this is about 15. That's another 3. Let's say 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, 14, 15. This is a leg, isn't it? And. Potentially we could get through this pretty quickly, potentially it could take a lot of time and heavy fighting. It looks like it opens up into a larger room here, so it could be a serious fight there. Right, I'll just leave things here. We don't need to rest quite yet. We have reasonable amount of spells to
lay. I'm ready.
Right, so we're actually in fairly good condition. And the extra level up does give you a bonus. Probably 3 to all saving throws. Just trying to get a decent grasp of where we stand. Defensive wise, we only have 2. I'm surprised the saving throws for the Paladin aren't this weak. It doesn't have anything particularly weak, but it doesn't have anything particularly well either. So I suppose it's the high perception. It doesn't have the constitution or resolution that usually, or dexterity that brings those up. Also one less level, naturally. Weak. Weak. At least we have mental abilities. They also have items that buff these, so it's not a fair comparison. 95. Cloak of an Eothasian priest, pulls will, resolve, intellect, level. Right. Right.